seven worlds. In our universe, there are seven worlds, shining in seven colors. Yellow, shining sun world. Orange, glowing moon world. Red, vivid fire world. Indigo, frosted water world. Green, tropical tree world. Blue, advanced metal world. Violet, earth and soil world. These worlds exist and act independent of one another. This has allowed them to develop and nurture unique cultures. And now, we've received a decree from the magnanimous Chou-Chou.
I'm gonna make everything in each of these worlds bow to me!
Chapter 2, Overwhelming Debut. Round up the heroes and demon lords, and make them my peons.
I'm loving the names of the chapters. They're just overly complex. Ooh, it's a lovely place. There's a giant sword there. Can we pick up the giant sword? Do we grow really big and pick up the sword? Sun World! Hello.
We're here. Solid ground at last. I was so sick of the ship's deck. It's been a while for me, too. Since getting punted out of the netherworld, I've just been floating around space. So? Gosh, how long's it been for me? It's been like 100 or maybe 1,000 years.
Aren't you exaggerating a little? Wow. Sunworld sure is pretty, isn't it?
Yep, it completely captures that archetypal fantasy vibe. A fitting first conquest.
Shall we have a look around? I've anchored G-Castle nearby.
We're just gonna leave it here? We should fly around in it.
Well, we'd stand out too much that way. I think it'd be a bit too intimidating. Flying around every world in our ship?
It doesn't really matter. Walking around lets us enjoy my new world even more. It's more fun this way. Aww. To be honest, I was hoping we could kind of fast-track this domination plan. There's no need to rush. Come on, let's get marching.
Indeed. Altus Ryotu. Oh, a critter is wandering around. They do that. Wait, it's an enemy. A monster. Touching that will initiate battle. That's one big sword. If you time it right, you can get the drop on an enemy by attacking them with your weapon. Do this with the A button, square, I think. This is an encounter attack. Don't forget about it. The opposite is true too. If an enemy gets you from the back, they will have the first strike. Be careful. Fair enough. Yep, it's square. Right, but as you can see, I've changed her costume. I didn't expect it to zoom in that fast, but okay. What's going on there? What? That's weird. It's like there's a bump there and it's causing things. We're doing that. Weird. Also, party! As you can see, well, maybe see, the text is really small for the names. We've got Nepgear, Neptune, and Noir now. Let's go have a look at the peon data. Peon ball? No, how do I view the peons? Equipment, I guess? I just want to view them. Clothing. There we go. There we are, we got Nepgear. She's actually called Nepgear this time. Awesome. We got Neptune. Alright, spin all the way around. Right, we've got Noir. There we go. And sub party, we got them too. Because we just have. And, oh, we ain't got them. I wanted to show off Vert and Cass. Cass was the first one to actually ask for a character to be made. Wasn't in any of the comments, it's a friend, so she was the first one to get one. Right, let's head around then. Where's an enemy? What is that anyway? Is that a rupee? No, it's not a rupee. I thought with the fantasy setting, maybe it was Zelda. Huh, what's that thing? Blah, blah, blah. You there. You called Lady Chou-Chou? What's that big sparkly thing? Oh, you found a large crystal. Let me explain what those are. Keep it quick. Got it. I will do my best. This crystal is of the large variety. Well, yeah, obviously, you can see it's quite large. The large ones emit a field trait on the current battlefield. Ooh. Unless you vanquish the enemies under the specified turn count, you will be rewarded with a game over. What? This concept is linked to the blast-off system, which I will explain later. No, explain it now! Just, what? If it can result in game over, let me know. Check the current field trait by pressing the RB button. I have no idea what that is on this, I guess R1. Just like with enemies, you can perform a moe kill against large crystals. If you manage to succeed, the effects will be extended across the entire battlefield. In other words, if you get the peon or item meters max, all the enemies on the field will transform accordingly. Also, if I go for the crystal, that's actually a good thing. In the case of frenzy, all enemies will enter a powered up state. Oh. Used wisely, this can defeat the enemy in one fell swoop. Conversely, if you fail, you'll be in for a world of hurt. That's it for large crystals. Carefully consider when to use them. Awesome. I believe Altus and Ryoto have been added to your party, starting with this battle. Well, it doesn't really matter because I'm not using them. Now you can perform linked arts. That's coming from Tails. Linked attacks. These are the conditions required to perform them. Blip, blip, blip. Being the movement radius of the other character and... Blip, blip, blip. The character's turn to move must be next on the list. Well, we've got a linkage for whoever characters we got, because we can see it at the top above the text box. Please keep these all in mind as you fight. Right, so we got Nep here. She can link with Chou-Chou. Right, let's take out this mushroom dude. Or should we go for the crystal? Can I go for the crystal? So if I go link mushroom. Ooh. This is bizarre. Go, go, Nep! I don't know what that said. Alright, so if I go for a moe kill on the big crystal, it's a sadist. So I want to abuse it, really, don't I? I want to hit it. Confession, maybe? Seems to have done well. Shampero!
All thanks to me.
Yeah. Awesome. Nepgear level up. Neptune level up. Noir level up. That's good. I like that. That's fun. Right, next. Oh, I pressed square. It's Noir. So can Nep attack this? Can't attack that, right. It's only Chou-Chou that can get moe attacks, I guess. So how do I end the turn? Defend.
Yeah. Who wants to become my Nep?
Let's go for the large crystal again. Moe kill on the large crystal. What's this crystal? Has it got different? It's bipolar. So I want to smile at it. Glare at it. And then be kind to it. Right? Yeah? Because it's bipolar. It's like good, bad, good, bad, good, bad. Maybe? Oh, that's not gone well.
Is that so bad?
Yeah, that didn't go well. What? Ooh. Yeah, it didn't go well at all. Let's do a link on the lesser bat. Tumbling doll. Awesome. Not so awesome that, but alright. A bit cruel. Hmm. So I've got a limited range I can run. That's, yeah. So, let's link on the lesser bat. Vable. Let's attack it. Just straight off attack. Before I selected voices for these characters, they don't seem to be saying anything. Bit weird, but alright. That's lesser bat dead. It's dead! Awesome. Field effects normal, so that's how I do get it. It is R1. Go on, get it. Let's link on it, Hornet B. Rainbow Tower. Okay, that's crazy. Awesome. How'd they end up at the moon? Winners! Well done, Net.
I'll let you pat me on the shoulder.
Chou-chou, level up. Is there any, like, items we can find?
Sweet, another peon. If we keep this pace, I'll be done here in no time flat.
How many people are on the planet?
Chou-chou?
Lady Chou-chou?
What? What's with your dumb faces?
I'm just gonna throw this out there, but how exactly do you intend to go about conquering these planets?
Indeed.
Isn't it obvious? I'm gonna make every single living thing in every world my peon. That means I rule the universe.
That's a lot of people to make peons.
Whoa! That's seriously impossible. I mean, how many creatures exist in the universe?
Oh yeah, and the monsters as well.
Huh? You think there are like thousands?
Thousands. Probably a bit more than that.
I had always figured her to be a little bit, innocent, but she's so...
Yeah.
I always knew Lady Chou-Chou was a tad naive, but she's so...
What's this? A mutiny? Don't look at me like I'm some clueless little girl.
You're definitely clueless.
Then what are you two suggesting instead? If you're gonna shoot your mouths off, let me hear your brilliant alternatives.
Actually, I haven't thought about it. I mean, I figured you had some kind of concrete plan.
Wow, you're both hopeless. Okay, listen. Your ability, Lady Chou-Chou, is to make anything into a subservient peon. That's more than enough to do it. All you have to do is make the strongest being in each world your peon.
So the leader of the world. Got it.
Oh, that makes sense. That wasn't half bad, Ryuto.
If only it were so easy. I feel like that logic's a bit forced.
Is it?
That's how it is. It's best if you just roll with it.
Okay.
But how do I know who's the strongest? I mean, I'd have to fight everything to find that out.
Don't sweat it. It's conventional that every world has a hero and a demon lord. Those two are the strongest by default.
So you have to defeat both?
Sounds about right.
Hero? Demon Lord? Are those the things we fought back on the ship?
No.
Yeah, that was a Demon Lord. To put it simply, they're the ones who are trying to rule each world.
That was a Demon Lord? So we've got to try and find the hero of this world.
Hey! I'm already playing that role!
They're a bit different from you. Their greed ends with their own world. Most are stopped by the heroes anyway.
Right. Heroes are allies of justice, and their only role is to save the world and beat the Demon Lord. It's a really sweet job. Everyone looks up to them.
Aren't you praising them a bit much?
No point keeping secrets. To be honest, I'm actually...
Yep, whatever. Gotcha. Basically, all I gotta do is beat up this hero and lord duo, yeah?
Yeah.
That's it. But Demon Lords are really evil. If you side with the heroes of each world and defeat the demons...
If we're talking about bad, I'm bad to the bone.
Yes, you sure are. We'll make you into the worst of the worst, the most evil in the universe.
If Lady Chou-Chou desires it.
Since we've cleared that up, Let's hurry and find those too soon to be peons. This place doesn't belong to them.
Let's go. Right, I was looking for items, wasn't I? See if there's any quest items or anything. Ooh, hello. What's this?
Can I use this?
So that's like a chest thing then. It went. It flew. What? Oh, it became a firework. That's cool. Right, where do I want to go? Is that anything? No, it's just a flower.
Can I use this?
Sugar candy. Yes,
our big chance.
Counter attack. Right, let's see. Oh, it's, I'm with Nep, aren't I? So let's do a link. Corner A. Tank. Oh, literally tanks. Got it. Of course. It makes complete sense that they'd come down on tanks.
Who wants to become mine next?
So I'm going link with all of them. I get it now. The blue thing is the link. Got it. Heard that hornet again. What are we gonna get? Pinball! What the?
Yeah.
I guess that's one way to attack an enemy. Oh dear. That didn't seem good, did it? No targets. You have to defend. You have to defend.
Who wants to become mine next?
Let's go with a Moe kill. Can we get the crystal? It's a large crystal, it's an ego. So I want to smile. Abuse it, I guess? And desperate.
Hands and knees, become my chair.
See how that works. Well, it didn't work that well, did it?
Huh? Hey!
I've seen Vable before. Alright, so attack. Undo it. No targets. Can I not get in range? Feels like I'm in range, but I guess I'm not. This crystal's in the way. That's not what I want. I want to defend. And we'll attack. Now I can get a linkage with all four. Awesome. That's not good. It's not good at all.
Who wants to become mine next?
We'll just go for it again.
Huh? Huh?
Dum 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 dum. Is it dead yet? Yes.
Carve your master's name into your body.
Okay, that's a bit dark, but okay. There goes! Rocket of Destiny. Boom! No you don't, no you don't. I'm still trying to find stuff. Alright, we got a tutorial. Hello! Blah blah blah. Here again. Have you gotten used to the battle system? Roughly, yeah, yeah. I'll explain skills and specials today. Oh, good. Both can be selected via the skill command. Skills require SP to use, whereas specials require SP and PP to use. Oh, PP stands for peon points, and they can be obtained by turning foes into peons or items. Skills and specials are more powerful than normal attacks, and some can even strike multiple opponents at once. Blip, blip, blip. What's more, each character has certain techniques they excel at, so please confirm those on the status screen. Use these effectively to defeat your enemies. Alright, so let's... skill. No skills. Come on, Nep. You want to get more skills.
Thank me.
Tank! Boom, boom. Bum, 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 bum. Ooh. Next up is an advanced fighting mechanic. It's called the Blast-Off System! As it sounds, the blast-off system is used to knock enemies into other foes, allies, or the battle's map borders. Using the blast-off system has several benefits. First, knocking enemies together will deal extra damage. Knocking foes into allies, crystals, or walls will also result in extra damage. Try to knock them all over the place. Second, someone hit by an enemy who has been blasted off may have their turn delayed. Third, the resulting G and Mugen points will increase based on the hit count from a successful blast off. One hit is added each time the enemy collides with another enemy, an ally, or a crystal. Here's how you perform a blast off attack! It just says on. And I can turn it on and off with X, wherever X is. Go to the skill menu. When you have the cursor on the technique, you will use the toggle blast off button with the A button. It's X in the screenshot, but alright. When toggled on, blast off will go into effect whenever the skill is used. Blip, blip, blip. Oh, this doesn't matter yet, but keep in mind that I'll explain the blast off power meter inside the red frame later. Alright. I've been talking for a while, so let's give it a try now. I haven't even tried the skills ones yet. Skill. Two part cuts. I'm trying to think. The on off isn't working. Pressing all the buttons, the on off isn't working at all. Okay. What did I press? Good, I'll continue. When the screen gets like this, choose the direction and distance for your blast-off attack. Direction first. If you're in the yellow part, use the directional buttons or the left stick to shift the hit's direction. Distance. This depends on the blast-off power meter. Use the LB and RB buttons to adjust this meter. It's pretty obvious, but the higher the blast-off meter's value, the farther the distance enemy will travel. So why won't I just do it for the full thing? The field effect created by the large crystal can also alter the distance an enemy will travel. Blip, blip, blip. The slippery field effect from one will increase the distance traveled. A sticky field has the opposite effect. After choosing the direction and distance, press the confirm button and blast off will commence. So, oh, I can see where it's going to. Uh-huh. I like that. Blast off power. I can't get more than that. Yeah, we'll go directional buttons. I like this. Let's see what happens. Like that. I like that. Ooh, what an overwhelming blast-off. With that, the blast-off power meter will decrease by the amount chosen. Using skills can restore the depleted meter. Look at the blast-off value in red, in the red frame, to see how much it will replenish. Use the blast-off option effectively to keep the tide of battle in your favor. So we're Nep needs a heal. So, item. Oh god, moderately restores HP. Moderately? That doesn't exactly tell me anything. We use it on Nep. Bacon and eggs. Oh no, Noir needs to heal as well. So, item. Bacon and eggs. Oh, that was the wrong character. That was the wrong character! I don't know. Yeah, you need to heal up Noir. Item, bacon and eggs, heal up Noir. Let's try for a Moe kill. So we got sadist. It's all sadist, so it's like, we'll hit them, we'll glare at them, and we'll be desperate, I don't know.
You love me.
So, right, can't go for another Moe kill, right. Can I toggle it now? I can toggle it now. So it was during the tutorial I couldn't toggle it. So toggle it off. And then do the smash? No. Clear? What does clear do? Inflict damage with ego affinity, multi-target. Right, let's do it. Ooh. That seemed quite powerful. Go for a Moe kill. We'll glare at it. Call it a crybaby, maybe? And we'll try confession.
You won't play with me? I like you.
Ooh. Got a link going on. It's quite complex, this game, but the tutorial is actually really good and it's taught me a lot already, and I like this. Defend. Let's go with a link. See what we get. Tag! That's probably my favorite one so far. Boom, 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 boom. No skill, no skill. Go with just a normal attack then. Gonna try and get a Moe kill on the crystal. It's a sadist, want to abuse it. They want to hit it. Gonna be the last one throws me off. It's like, what's best for that? Try kind, just because. Nothing seemed to move it. Oh well. Alright, let's get this one then. Link. Label. Done. Awesome. Level up. Level up. Level up. Level up. Alright. Oh, what? You can't do that. That's just not fair. That's just not on at all, that. Let's try with this.
Thank me.
Up step destroyer. Bum 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 bum. This one dead. So what's the crystal? Look at the Moe. Crystal is Terse. I don't know, we'll try Crybaby. We'll just press the first one and see what happens. Do I have more options here actually? No. We'll try and be kind, I don't know. See how it changes the thing at the bottom. Oh, not good. Ooh, that wasn't good. I would just go for a normal set. No, we'll go for a skill. And we'll try bouncing it, maybe. Let's do that, see what happens to Nep.
Get it now?
I got it now. Let's go for Link. Do-ka-dum. It's the moon! And you're gone. Well done, Noir! Yeah, let's go down here. There's another one there. Another rocket here, though.
Can I use this?
Flimsy spear. Who can use a flimsy spear? Who can use a flimsy spear? I mean, I could go up and use the DLC, but we won't. Ooh, that's just the skills. No one used a flimsy spear. We got old panties, but I don't know. It's a sword. Clap clap break. Oh wait. Where's the flimsy spear? Probably wouldn't be best for that character, that's the thing. Don't know at all. I don't know, we'll just hold on to it and fix that all later. Let's wander around. Not that way though, because that feels like the way we're meant to go eventually, so we'll go back and check for items. Try to avoid enemies as much as I can. Is that the way I came from? That's the way I came from. So we eventually went that way, I went that way. Oh no, we've been everywhere. Got it. So this is the way we are meant to go. Getting lost in this place. Alright, let's head for the infinity symbol.
We've finally reached civilization.
It's a house.
Come on, just find someone and grill them about this hero person and demon lord.
You won't find either of them so easy. We have to carefully search the entire world.
Well, there he is, I guess. Don't know which one, though. Could be the demon lord, for all we know.
What was that? Is it coming from over there?
Okay. Is he smashing pots?
Jeez, look at him, throwing vases around without saying a single word.
That is so Link.
He's certainly a dangerous man. Let's keep our distance, kids. Oh, look it! He waltzed into someone else's home.
This is definitely Link.
Places he's searching. I don't think he got permission to look in there.
So it's like a typical game character. Like the player's perspective is just going to every house and check every place for items.
He's not just a dangerous man. He's a crook, a criminal.
Well.
Witnessed a crime. I guess panty thieves do exist. I'm all for acts of evil, but he seemed kind of icky. He left vase fragments all over the place. That's really dangerous. What if someone steps on them?
Don't forget, the people living in the home let him do it. They probably think he's too dangerous to approach.
That is a hero.
Is it? Oh yeah, it would be, wouldn't it? Thinking about it, because he'd be the protagonist of whatever game he thinks he's in.
Wanna repeat that?
He's a hero, probably.
You're a real comedian, aren't you? Didn't you just say that heroes are cool and everyone looks up to them?
That's still the truth. I wouldn't lie to you. If a hero sees a clay pot or vase, he's inclined to break it. If he sees a dresser, he's compelled to open it.
That's crazy talk. What kind of mental affliction is that?
Now, at least we found one of the people we were looking for.
Ugh, just the thought of making that sicko my peon gives me goosebumps.
Don't be like that. I know how you feel, but remember, it's for the sake of universal domination.
Indeed. Well?
There he is, the hero from before.
Something still makes me feel unwashed and greasy about this.
No excuses. Suck it up and turn him into your adoring little underling.
Wait, someone else is with him.
Oh, you're right. You're crapping me.
What?
Sir Skyheart? I'm really, really embarrassed.
He's got a nosebleed, doesn't he?
Sandy, how many times must I remind you? It's not Sir Skyheart, but Lord Hero.
I apologize for my... Wait, why must I don this bikini?
The defense parameters are uncharacteristically high. Is there a problem?
I get it.
Yes, I just said it was embarrassing. Please allow me to wear ordinary apparel.
Request denied. Only the hero has the right to decide what his fellow party members may equip.
I'm not another party member. Please let me return to my castle.
Is this an another mental affliction that all heroes seem to show?
Oh, he's off on one, look.
Bikini! My holy cod!
Cod?
If you perform your bloody geyser trick here, you're pathetic. Okay, enough of this. Hey, you!
Huh? Who are you?
Oh, do you need to ask?
Who am I? Who do you think you are? Parading a poor girl around in a tiny bikini.
Oh dear! Please don't look at me!
Too late.
I only do what is proper for a hero.
Proper my ass?
Ah, I know your type. You're upset that I haven't allowed you to wear a bikini too.
Oh, this guy needs to be taken out.
Huh?
A moment. I've many other swimsuits. Let me see if one of these will fit your petite frame.
I don't need a stinking bikini. Why should I wear one anyway?
Oh, that's not it? Then I don't have any more words to waste on you. Scram.
Oh, this is... Ooh.
I still got something to say!
Wow, I've never seen our dear little Chou-Chou get snubbed like that.
He's definitely a hero. A cut above the rest.
Oh man, this guy's pissed me off. I'm gonna pee on his ass right now!
You just do something?
Did it not work?
Ineffective? So, I don't get you going or something?
Get me going? I've no idea what you're babbling about. I'll waste no more time on you. Let's march, Sandy.
Oh, please save me!
We tried.
Go, spell that magically returns me safely to the castle.
Hey, wait! No fair!
I pegged him as just another pervert. But he seems to be a bona fide hero. Chou-Chou's charms actually failed, too.
That was just a fluke. No matter what, he'll be all mine.
Oh, that was crazy. Nope, nothing there. Right, okay. To the castle! Check the mailbox? No? Okay. Where was that giant sword, anyway? There. That's a huge sword. This is an infinity there, so we'll head this way. And get the rocket!
I found a treasure!
Normal bra! Good, because I needed that. Because I did have one of my first time going through the beginning. Second time I didn't, for some reason. So there we go, we've matched what we had before now. What is it? Is this anything, or is it just... It's just there for effects, alright?
Okay, settle down and be my peon!
It ran away!
Another fluke. Why?
You failed here and with that hero. Maybe your ability isn't omnipotent.
That's a big fat lie. I'm just feeling a little clammy.
This is no good. We've already hit a yellow light in our travel plans. If we fail, then I've also... Okay, in this situation, we'll ask someone who you made into your peon directly.
Someone who was made into a peon? So, me?
Duh! How did it feel to become her peon? Did it hurt or make you cry?
Lady Chou-Chou was just so darn cute, and my heart was instantly hers, so... Hey! What are you making me say?
Then you became hers because you fell head over heels for her? Or did you become a peon first and love her after?
This is way too embarrassing!
Please answer. It's very important.
The first time I laid my eyes on her... I thought, wow, what a cutie! And then I became her loyal underling.
So, if this means that, then that must mean this. Chou-Chou, it's just a theory, but...
Huh? Spill!
I believe your ability to gain peons is only effective against those who find you attractive.
Huh? What?
What's more, it appears the only people who like you are of a similar age and have underdeveloped tastes in girls.
That's not true at all!
Over 90% of the people in the universe think I'm cute.
Don't turn a blind eye to reality. But if that's really the case, then our plan has failed. My domination scheme!
It's indisputable that Lady Chou-Chou is a total hottie. But different strokes for different folks. I mean, otherwise.
It's dumb and annoying to admit, but... If that's the case, I just gotta make everyone think I'm cute, right?
Yes, but there are limits. No matter how you dress or make yourself up, you're still you. Your tiny boobs, for one.
If that's all there is, I'll just do this!
Huh? Lady Chou-Chou, what are you...
Huh?
What?
At least they're bigger than yours now, dear Auntess.
What?
Chou-Chou, is that you?
Don't ask, don't tell, darling. See? Now even the fools who like big cans won't be able to resist me.
Wait! How can you act like that was normal?
So, in other words, basically, you can change your physical form?
What? You mean you guys can't?
There's no way we could!
It's strange. What kind of creature can change its whole body?
What? I don't know what you're saying, but I think I understand. You're so weak, you only have, like, 3 forms, right?
I can barely maintain one!
Well, us normal people... Never mind, I'm not really human, so there's that. But I can't change forms.
Really? Being a human sucks.
Wow. I think I heard my internal logic shatter into 1 billion pieces just now.
Normal people can't live up to what this girl's notion of what normal is. You mentioned 3 forms for weaker individuals. So does that mean you have more than that tucked away?
Naturally, I'm the undisputed god of the universe. My power eclipses the common people a zillionfold. I count 1, 2, 3, 7! 7 different forms.
Zillionfold? 7's hardly double a weakling's power.
Hardly double spells twice the trouble, so they say. Never mind.
Oh, that's right. I just remembered I never showed you. Well, I'll bring them all out now. Whee!
I'm so sorry for not showing you. When I'm in this form, I'm so timid.
This is the only time I'll let you see me like this. Got it? For running around and being crazy energetic!
I had neglected showing you this form, had I not? It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance at last.
When I'm like this, I'm kinda, you know, out of it. That's it! How'd you like my show?
Those were... all... you?
I can't believe they were the same girl.
I bet that one of these forms will get the hero's sword a-swinging. Let's get moving. Next time we see that guy, he'll bow before me.
Amazing! Only Lady Chou-Chou could do such impossible things! I'll follow her to the end of the universe!
Oh, goodness. This is quite a shock. What is that girl, really?
Oh. Okay. That's it. So basically, she can transform into 7 different personalities. That is bizarre. Also, one of them is Sadie, which is kind of worrying. Anyway. Another new game feature, this is Lady Chou-Chou's exclusive ability, Form Change. So, transform. Why didn't you call it transform? I see, we were real creative with the game terminology. Call it transform. Shut up, you got a problem with it? No, not at all, just trolling. On the field, Lady Chou-Chou's form can be changed by pressing the LB button. If you plan ahead and shift your form based on the enemy's moe and mood preferences, moe kills will go smoothly. Awesome. Form change can also be performed mid-battle. Press the LB button during Lady Chou-Chou's turn or choose Form Change from the command list. Form change can only be used once before your turn. The number of times you can change per battle is limited to. You can reset the count by returning to G Castle instead of using it recklessly. Use it strategically. I should also take this opportunity to explain charm levels. Huh? There's more of this junk? Please don't say it like that. This is an important gameplay mechanic. Charm levels are precisely that. A numeric value of Lady Chou-Chou's charms. This value will increase as you gather more and more Shumperoos. Increasing your charm level will let you access stronger Moe kills and will raise the times you may form change in battle. Oh. Get into the pattern of collecting Shumperoos and raising your charm level. This makes it easier to get more of us. Please gather many Shumperoos and raise your charm level, Lady Chou-Chou! Oh, I like this. Let's get this rocket though.
Can I use this?
Junk sword. Doesn't look like we can use it. Save point. Shall we save here before we carry on? I think this is a good point to save. We've just seen a transformation thing, so yeah. We'll save and we'll see you in the next part!